Buenos días. Una buena.
Good morning. A good piece of news. Gender ideology has no future. It'll self-destroy. This is not something that Citizen Go says, but rather a lesbian. What is this based on? On the fact that sex is biological and not a social construct. It cannot be changed. That lesbian is here amongst us today, this morning. Her name is Miriam Ben-Shalom. She was an instructing sergeant in the US Army, but when she manifested her condition as lesbian, she was sent to the back lines. She founded the Association of Gay and Lesbian Veterans in the US, and she fought at the courts until judges proved her right and determined that the Constitution of the United States had been violated when they put her away from service. Now, Miriam Ben-Shalom suffers another kind of discrimination, the discrimination of gays and lesbians because of her opinions on them and on trans. So, and she opposes the change of sex by children with gender dysphoria. She has founded an organization together with another colleague to create exclusive areas without transgender males. Thank you very much for joining us on this first worldwide conference on gender, sex, and education, and offering her valuable statement. Miriam Ben-Shalom.
Good morning. Buenos dias. My name is Miriam Ben-Shalom. I come to you from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, United States. And I represent Hands Across the Aisle, Women in Coalition. This is a coalition of conservative and progressive women in the United States working on the transgender issue. Most specifically, we are concerned with the issue of transing children, keeping women and children safe in public spaces. Okay, can you? Okay, we're a diverse group of women. We're not shy, we have our disagreements, but we're united together to work on keeping women and children safe, and especially to keep children safe, because children are the most impressionable and they're the most fragile in a society. Okay. Women are in our coalition can agree that sex-based legal protections must make reference to biological sex, not gender identity. Laws and policies that redefine sex as gender identity are regressing, relying on outdated stereotypes. I am a woman. I don't wear high heels. I don't wear makeup. And if I wear a dress, I look like a Bulgarian lady tank driver. Nonetheless, I'm a woman. And I resent being told that I should wear high heels, lots of pancake makeup, and whatever else I'm told that I'm supposed to do. Gender ideology erases the opportunities and protections that women have longed for. My body, the words that I use for my body, I am now being told by physicians, doctors, and educators that I ought not to use those words, that they're transphobic. What is the fearfulness about it? I don't know. But my vagina is not a front hole. I did not chest feed my daughter, I breastfed her. And for saying so, I'm not being transphobic. Gender ideology is inherently problematic to children. Children are impressionable. They don't know any better. And I am angered, as is our coalition, beyond belief that children who cannot get a credit card on their own, that children who cannot make decisions about education on their own, that they cannot engage in contracts, are being told it's okay to put lots of chemicals in your body, and are not being honestly told that there are consequences for that. Okay, Ben Carson, we went to talk to Ben Carson, who works for the housing department in the United States government, to say we don't want, you know, you have to stop placing men in only homeless shelters. Okay, in the United States, as of right now, any man who self-identifies as a woman can get into any space that was formerly female or woman only. That includes domestic abuse shelters, shelters for homeless women, and we ask that that not be done. We spoke out against adding gender identity to birth certificates. Really? When you're born, you can pretty much tell what the baby is, can't you? Think about it. Gender identity of a newborn child? You want to be an X? Doesn't make any sense. We called on public school systems to reject policies that endorse gender ideology. The very idea that a young teenage boy who is intact should be allowed into a woman's locker room or a woman's bathroom is somewhat inane. In fact, there have been places where this has happened, and it was the young girls who rose up and said, no, we don't like this. They did not, pardon me to be use a military term, they didn't want to shower next to a swinging dick. Okay? Okay, we testified at the Texas State Legislature on behalf of a bill that would ensure privacies in intimate spaces. Trans activists like to say that there is no danger to women, that transgendered males identifying as trans do not do any crimes. The fact of the matter is the rise of voyeurism and other crimes like that has risen since access has been provided to any male who says that he is a woman. In Texas alone, there is a federal prison there which has housing for male prisoners and female prisoners, and they've integrated so-called trans women into the female section. And the women were insulted about it because they said that these so-called trans women were standing at the showers with full erections, they were intact, and making sexual remarks and sexually harassing the women. They were also insisting that they be given tampons or menstrual pads. What they would use them for is beyond my comprehension. I have a suggestion as to where I would put them, but that's neither here nor there. Okay, we submitted a letter to every Canadian senator in opposition to Bill C-16 calling for support of single-sex spaces for women. Our coalition is absolutely opposed to allowing men into women-only spaces, and I don't know what's happening in Canada. I've oftentimes thought that Canada was that most civil of countries, but they seem to have lost their way in terms of the transgender issue. And Canadian women now who are speaking out against transgender ideology are being subjected to terrible pressure, including loss of jobs and loss of income. Hands Across the Aisle Coalition is committed to working together and rising above our political and ideology and religious differences. I'm probably the only progressive here today speaking out, and I dare say I'm probably the only Jew. When Abraham went to the mountain, he said to God, "Ine ani, here I am, here, and here I am." Okay? In our coalition, we have our tiffs. We do have some disagreements, but we don't allow it to get in our way. We are focused, we work together, and I would say that the sisterhood that we all experienced is really rather remarkable. We support each other, we care about each other, and we work together. We use all the resources that we have at hand to work to not allow gender ideology to take the place of common sense. Okay, sex, just as a little primer, used to mean women got pink, although that's not historically always true, and women got blue. I'm XX, this fellow over here is XY. It's biology. It's not bigotry. Nowadays, sex has been redefined to mean something, anything that anybody says it is. Okay, just for your information, I identify today as a redwood tree. you will address me as your leafiness, and my pronoun of choice is leafy. And if you don't call me your leafiness or whatever, you have committed literal violence on me, and you are engaging in genocide against me. Okay? Women are losing the right to use their language as giving birth, breastfeeding, menstruation, proper terms for biology, for our female body parts. Sex. Two main categories. XY, XX. It's a reproductive thing. It talks about reproductive functions. Gender is an artificial construct of a society. It's trans ideologists will say that it's our identity is determined by feelings without any reference to the body. From a feminist perspective, okay, gender is also understood as the behavioral or cultural or psychologically traits associated with one sex. I guess that makes me non-binary, but I'm not transgender. It's kind of interesting. I don't know of a single human being that is 100% according to what the gender expectations of a society is. Okay, sex and gender in trans ideology, sex is assigned at birth. Oh, you can be an X, and if we say, oh, I have a baby girl or I have a baby boy, it's like that's transphobic. Okay, sex has become a social construct. How you can make biology a social construct is beyond my comprehension. I will say that I'm not a scientist. I was a teacher of English for 37 years, and I was a drill sergeant in the Army, okay, which is another thing entirely. But I don't understand how you can say that biology and sex is irrelevant. Gender is the innate or true identity. As I said, I identify this morning as a redwood tree. You know what to call me. There you go. Gender identity is defined by sex stereotypes and is regarded as being more important than the body. Well, if you like artificial hormones, if you like plastic surgery, I guess that might be true. What's the problem that we're having today? Gender has replaced sex. How many of you go to a doctor's office and you answer the mile-long, 27-page questionnaire about your health habits and what you're taking and everything else, and you ask, what's your gender? Really? I can't tell you how many times I have crossed out gender and then written a whole long spiel about gender is an artificial construct of a society. However, my biological sex is XX, and I can't believe that doctors even do this, ask what their gender is. In the English language, I can't speak about any place else. Gender has become the word to use in place of sex, which is inaccurate and completely wrong and ungrammatical as far as I'm concerned. Gender identity is irrelevant when, oh, if you have a heart attack, men and women respond differently to that sort of thing. Hold on. Technology. How do I go back? I don't know. They had the one there, and now I don't know where I am in the PowerPoint. Back. Okay, back. There we go.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you very much. Pardoni me.
You want the chair?
No. Okay, men who identify as transgender don't need pap smears, but they will ask for them. Okay, if you want to report a criminal, okay, what do you do? You know, you could say, well, it was a cock in a frock. It's a guy in a dress, okay? But how do you go about reporting that? If you need to stay in a homeless shelter, or you've been a victim of domestic abuse and you have to go in there, how are you going to feel if there's a 6-foot-7-inch male who identifies as transgender right there with you in the same room? People are not taking women into account. But in these sorts of situations, sex matters. Okay, the erasure of women, in my opinion, is what's occurring here today. Okay, the definition of women in law and culture has been redefined to include biological males. I don't care, frankly, what you wear or how you see yourself. You can call yourself whatever you wish, but don't expect me to believe your fantasy, your delusion, and don't expect me to call you something that you're not. We find that women are losing the ability to assemble outside the presence of men. Because of the pressure that was put on the Michigan Women's Music Festival, the festival, after 40 years, has been shut down and it doesn't exist anymore because the trans activists said they were transphobic, which they were not. Nobody ever said trans women couldn't come, but they made an issue out of it. You see women wanting to have, in Vancouver, the women's bookstore, books that were published 20, 30 years ago, the trans activists came in there and threw them down and poured wine and other fluids on them, saying they were transphobic. The very idea that women would dare to have a bookstore selling books by women for women was transphobic. Loss of sex-based data collection and crime statistics. Every crime that a male who identifies as transgender is now put on my shoulders as a woman. And I got to tell you, I resent it mightily. Okay, loss of sex-based educational scholarships. In the United States, we did have single-sex colleges. They aren't anymore. And that angers me. And furthermore, some of these males who identify as trans are taking women scholarships that were open to women. The resources, which were few and far between, are even fewer now and much more far between. In athletics, I don't watch the Olympics. I refuse to, because the Olympic Committee has said that males who identify as trans can now take places on women's sports teams. Oh, please. You know, they can take estrogen, they can do what they will, but they still have a male body, they still have male musculature, and they still have the strength. I don't know of too many 6'7" women playing basketball. Here are some examples if you take a look at. Down below, the boxer, her name is Fallon. He severely injured a woman boxer that she went against. The basketball players, can you guess who the man is? Do you need a moment to figure it out? Okay, the weightlifter is an Australian guy. And he couldn't make it in men's sports, so he went into women's sports. I don't know about you, but I don't think it's a woman. Something's telling me that in my insides, okay? Okay, gender and sex. Gee, I don't know about you, but I've been called transphobic. I actually don't think that transgender people should be subjected to discrimination. They should have the same human rights and protections as everybody else. But as I said, do not ask me to buy into their mental illness, their delusion, their fantasy. I'm sorry they aren't women. You may differ with me if you so choose, but I don't think so. And I would feel very uncomfortable in a shower or in a locker room with people who looked like that because I know they aren't like me. Okay, children, this is our focus. It's a destructive lie to tell a child that she was born in the wrong body. Probably 85 to 95% of kids who experience what's called gender dysphoria, they grow out of it, and they go on and have a good life just as they were as either males or females with no problem. Children and teens with non-stereotypical behaviors and preferences are made to believe that they are transgender. I worry what they would have called me as I was growing up because my father took me hunting and fishing. I still hunt, I still fish. I changed the oil in my car, and it's not because I'm a lesbian either. It's because I don't have the money and I can do it. You know what I mean? So I'd hate to think of what they would have done to me. This is especially horrific to me because young lesbians are now being pressured into transitioning. They are told, oh, you're not a lesbian, you're a man. You should become a man. And so it's almost like a genocide on gay kids. Young gay boys are being told, oh, you this is what you want. Well, you're probably a woman. And it's horrific. Children who medically transition are potentially sterilized by so-called gender-affirming treatments. Why would a movement go after children to damage them for the rest of their life, to subject them to health problems, the likes of which we can't even begin to comprehend fully and completely right now? What kind of people are they that they go after children this way? There is a term for it. It's called pedophilia, and you may not agree with me, but so much of the outreach, if you go on like Facebook or whatever and see the various sites that transgender activists have, I don't know, it makes me very uncomfortable. And in fact, there have been transgender activists who said, you know, like, well, it's perfectly normal for children to have sexual feelings, and, you know, if they turn to an adult, you know, that's normal also. This is what's going on. Now, this is going to be shocking. Take a deep breath. Okay, trans kids, transwear. What we have here for four-year-olds, five-year-olds, for girls who think they're boys, okay, we have latex penises. Okay, you can buy these readily on the internet in the United States. Okay, what the girl is wearing there is a breast binder, which really does cause a lot of health problems if you bind your breasts for women. Okay, in the corner you have kids who are transgender, but this is the sort of things, and notice, just for any of you, see, Jews are included because there's a circumcised model, and if you're not Jewish, there's an uncircumcised model of the artificial penis for children, just so you should know. Okay, this person is sewing underwear for kids who want to pack, okay? It's kind of interesting. Due to high demand, the EZP Junior is currently unavailable. That's the way little one, but here's some more examples of penises. That's a male identifying as trans sewing underwear. Does this sit ill at ease with any of you out there in the audience, by any chance? Does it make you feel uncomfortable? It makes me feel very uncomfortable. Okay. I say let kids be kids. Okay, girl, it's a human child, it's a female. In maturity, she will produce eggs, ova. Boy is a human male child. In maturity, he will produce sperm. Okay, wear pants, it's still a girl. Plays with trucks, still a girl. Wears a dress, it's still a boy. Wants to play with a doll, still a boy. What's the problem? We aren't dealing here with intersex and infertile conditions because they don't nullify the definitions of male and female. The problem, anybody who bullies children for personal taste, beating up a little boy who wears a pink coat to school, or telling a little boy that he was born in the wrong body, is bullying, and it's a lie. And if you're parents out there, you need to stand up for this and take care and protect your children. Children do not need to be subjected to this. Okay, sex and gender cannot exist side by side in the law. It can't happen, because how do you know anybody's gender other than what they say? Gender says there are infinite human identities. Sex says there are two. And the anomalies, intersex people or infertile people, do not negate that binary. Gender says our bodies are irrelevant. Sex says our bodies matter. Gender says our identity is a state of mind, feels, F-E-E-L-Z, okay, that's the term we use for it in the United States, whereas sex says we have a physical reality. I think human beings are a lot more than feels. Gender says we choose who we are. Sex says we are conceived as male or female. What you do beyond that is your own business. Transgender activists are working at every level of society to erase biological sex as a human reality, and that frightens me. Okay, they also engage in violence against women. Here's some pictures. Comply or die, good grief. These are Antifa people marching with pink and blue baseball bats. And this tranny kills TERFs. I understand there were some people, you know, protesting nicely, but they had rocks in their pockets. send me out there. Hine ani, hine ni, here I am here. You need to face down those bullies. I mean, I'm glad and I thank you to the police, but we needed to be out there saying, uh-uh, no. I mean, I asked to go out there. I would have confronted them because they need confronting. They don't need for us to be afraid. Okay, it's turned bloody. This is a 60-year-old woman in Britain who was at a book fair, and she was not even selling any pamphlets or any information that were anti-trans. She was taking pictures, and they came and they beat her up. They punched her out. Wow. I didn't do it. Okay, I didn't. And it's the suppression of freedom of speech. It's sort of like you can speak if you want to, as long as you agree with them, and if you don't, you're disallowed to even have a forum. One of the things I cherish about Hands Across the Aisle, Women in Coalition, is the fact that universally it has been people on the right, primarily Christians, the Heritage Foundation, as an example, that has supported us. They have afforded us courtesy, kindness, and consideration. I have never been ill-treated by anybody from the right. Quite the contrary, from the left. Never has the left afforded us a forum so we could present what it is that we have to say. And it's interesting that here, where's the leftist organization supporting this? It's Athir Oyer, did I say it right? I thought it was a Hebrew word when I first said it, because I would have pronounced it as Chatzir Oir. Sorry. It's a Christian organization, a conservative organization that's supporting this. Where are the people from the left? They aren't there. This is Jeremiah Maya Byrne wearing a blood-spattered T-shirt calling for violence against lesbians and feminists at the San Francisco Pride Parade. He claims that his T-shirt has the blood of TERS. He says he punched TERS. Here I am. Care to try it? That's the attitude that we need to take, because allowing people like this to spread their bullshit, their balderdash, their lies, is so wrong. I'm lucky. I can stand up and speak out. I'm retired. I have nothing to lose, and that makes me dangerous. And I'm happy to be dangerous, because voices against this sort of silliness are few and far between. People are afraid. I'll give you a hint about one thing. If you really want to hurt somebody or do some damage, you aren't going to put it on social media, okay? If you really want to do something, you're going to do it quietly. You're not going to tell people. I was in the military. It's called tactics. Okay, here are some tweets and other things that came. Dead TERFs just make the world a safer place. TERF is trans-exclusionary radical feminists. I say it's totally energizing radical feminists. Difference in interpretation. TERFs make me want to go on a murderous rampage. Kill all the TERFs. I will personally punch every TERF in the face if I have to. Here I am. Go for it. Bring it on. Okay, cis people are mad about TERFs getting punched or whatever, but my election platform is that I will kill every TERF and eat their rib cages. Okay, I don't care about your feelings or winning your support. I want you blow up with fertilizer bombs. Here I am. Bring it on. Go for it. Char the Butcher with his die cis scum tattoo. Okay? You're not scum, by the way, just to let you all know, and you don't need to die. Okay, violent threats against women. As a trans woman, my ideal future would be something like The Handmaid's Tale. Are you familiar with The Handmaid's Tale? It's a novel set in a dysphoric 10 minutes, okay, in the future. Non-binary people, cis men, would be ruling the class, cis women, trans men, and assigned female at birth, non-binary folks would be breeding slaves, and so on. This is what they want. What can you do? Don't be afraid to extend your hand across the aisle. Look here, I may be the only progressive Jewish lesbian in this place right now. Do you see my hand? I offer my hand to you. We can work together on this issue. I can teach you how Hands Across the Aisle Women in Coalition was formed. Keep speaking the truth that biology is not bigotry. Defend women and children by standing up and speaking out publicly. We do have a website, okay? Whoop, go back. Okay, www.handsacrosstheaislewomenincoalition.com. We have a Facebook page, but you have to be vetted to become a member there, and right now it's women only. And we have a Twitter account at biologicalwomen.com. Okay, finally, and at the end, you're gonna be hearing a lot of stuff. It's serious. It gets bothersome. So my sense of humor, because I'm Jewish, is when you have something dark, make fun. So here we have Monty Python, and Stan doesn't like his sex.
Creo que el punto de vista de Judith es muy válido. Siempre que el partido no olvide que es el derecho inalienable de todo hombre.
O mujer.
O mujer. Ser liberado.
O liberada.
O liberada.
De acuerdo.
Gracias, hermana.
O hermana.
O hermana. ¿Por dónde iba?
Ya habías terminado.
Ah, sí.
Además, también es derecho de todo hombre.
O mujer.
¿Qué fijación tienes con las mujeres, Stan? Nos estás distrayendo.
Las mujeres también tienen derecho a participar en nuestro movimiento. ¿Por qué te preocupas tanto por las mujeres, Stan? Yo quiero ser mujer.
¿Qué?
Quiero ser una mujer. Desde ahora, quiero que me llaméis Loretta.
¿Qué?
Es mi derecho como hombre.
¿Por qué quieres ser Loretta, Stan?
Porque quiero tener hijos.
¿Quieres tener hijos?
Los hombres también tienen derecho a tener hijos si quieren.
Pero tú no puedes parir.
No me oprimas.
No es que te oprima, Stan, es que no tienes matriz. ¿Dónde vas a gestar el feto? ¿Lo vas a meter en un baúl?
Chicos, tengo una idea. Estamos de acuerdo en que no puede parir por no tener matriz, lo que no es culpa de nadie, ni siquiera de los romanos. Pero sí puede tener el derecho a parir.
Buena idea, Judith. Lucharemos contra el opresor por tu derecho a parir hijos, hermano. Digo, hermana.
¿Y eso de qué sirve?
¿El qué?
¿De qué sirve defender su derecho a parir si no puede parir?
Es un símbolo de nuestra lucha contra la opresión.
Es un símbolo de su lucha contra la realidad.
Thank you. You got to have a little levity. Now, before I go, I probably have like 5 minutes left. You got questions for me? Here I am. I am here. Ask away. Don't be shy. I've heard it all. No questions?
But es por escrito.
It's in writing. It's in writing. The questions are in writing. I'm going to be asking the questions in Spanish. They have been written down, so I'll be... Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear the translator? Can you hear me?
Ah. Nos sentamos, nos sentamos, nos sentamos. Sit, sit down. Voy a hacer...
I'm going to be asking a few questions that the audience has sent. If anyone else wants to ask a question, we have around 10 minutes for a Q&A session with Miriam Ben-Shalom. Can you hear me, Miriam? Can you make a gesture if you can hear me? Can you hear the English version? Can you hear me?
No. En Estados Unidos...
Can you hear me now, Miriam? Can you hear me now? Can you hear the translator? Can you hear me now? Could you? Okay, good. Thank you. So President Trump in the US has been capable of limiting abortions by ending with Planned Parenthood financing, by having pro-life judges fighting for life and against abortion. Nonetheless, it seems that with gender ideology, President Trump in the US has not had such a decisive attitude. What does Miriam think about President Trump's attitude with regards to gender ideology?
Well, as you know, now the Department of Education associated with the United States government will not allow the affirming of the transgender ideology or identity. I don't much care for President Trump, okay, I have to be honest with you. But that he's at least taken a stance and said, no, this is ridiculous, is heartening to me. I only wish he would be stronger in his statement that women are entitled and children are entitled to safety, their human rights in their own spaces. I'm not happy that on his stance with abortion, but that's another thing entirely, and I won't discuss that here, because that's not relevant.
Muy bien.
Very well, another question. You have given us the example of how people who defend marriage and who defend the difference between men and women in the U.S. have been facing people who belong to the LGBT lobby. What could we do in Spain where a law has just been passed or is about to be passed, a law that was promoted by a communist party called Podemos that wishes to impose gender ideology in Spain? What could we citizens do to fight a law that limits our freedom of expression and our liberties, our freedoms? How could we in Spain oppose ourselves to such a law that Podemos is going to pass, a communist party in the Congress of Deputies, that is the parliament here in Spain?
I need a little help. Okay, it's not clear to me what the law is that they're trying to pass. Can you explain a little bit more for me to give a cognizant answer?
Ah, sí, es.
Yes, it's a law. It's a law that is trying to promote, that is being promoted by a party in Spain at the Congress in order to impose gender ideology to our children so that we may force children to change their sex, to forbid the reassigning of original sex, to prosecute parents when they try to educate their children, etc.
Okay, I understand now. First and foremost, in unions, there is strength, okay? Where you have groups of people come together and work on this issue and this issue only, do not allow abortion rights or gay marriage or anything else to interfere. Also, you need to start speaking the truth that biology is not bigotry. Have you scientists here in Spain, have you doctors, have you psychologists, have you psychiatrists who would be willing to stand up and speak? Yes, I know they may lose their jobs or they may be threatened, but in unions there is strength. If one here and one there speaks against it, you aren't going to have much success. But in unions with many, you will experience the success because you're not lying, you are telling the truth. I don't understand how anybody can force gender ideology on anybody. The original title of my speech was Au Rebord. It's a French term. It's the name of a novel written by a fellow by the name of Huyman. And it means against the grain or against nature. It's a novel that talks about a guy who, you know, didn't want anything to do with nature, and so he sets himself up almost to the point where he dies. This is so against nature. How can you substitute an artificial construct with a biological reality? And that's what you need to teach people. But you need to do it together. Conservatives, liberals, and progressives together. Just like Hands Across the Aisle is doing. You can do it. You can do it. It's not that hard. You focus on gender ideology and the falseness of what it is. You will win. In unions, there is strength.
Muy bien. Otra pregunta.
Okay, and there's another question. It is a question of personal nature. How come Miriam Ben-Shalom, who's a lesbian, did not accept the thesis of gender ideology when she was younger a few years ago? Why didn't you accept this ideology, although you were a lesbian and you were probably under the pressure of lesbians who did belong to those lobbies, to LGBT lobbies? How come you didn't give in?
A woman. I'm a female. I used to menstruate. I have breasts. My chromosomes are XY. That I'm a woman who loves other women. Just to let you know, you can take a deep breath and let it go, because my life partner and I have been together for 25 years, okay? I wonder what they would have done with me as a child, you know, whether I would have been forced to trans or not. I don't think the T belongs with the LGB, okay? My sexuality is part and parcel of my humanity. Just like heterosexuality is part and parcel, if you're heterosexual, is who you are. Transgender is not a sexuality. It doesn't even belong with the L, G, and the B. It has nothing to do with sexual orientation. It's autogynephilia. It's a fantasy. It's a delusion. I'm no genius, but I was a teacher for 37 years. I know how to do research. I know how to think. I engage in critical thinking. Why in bloody hell would I buy somebody who says I should be a man when I'm very content being the woman that I am? I kind of like being a woman, you know? I don't want to be something I'm not. I look at the tortured lives of some of the women who transitioned and then detransitioned, who decided, you know, at some time that, you know, this was wrong. I know several, you know, young lesbians who went that way for a while and now are back to being their normal selves. And it's like, they all say how uncomfortable it really is. It's, I guess, I was a drill sergeant in the United States Army, okay? I taught other people how to be soldiers. I was a teacher of English for 37 years. I have a BA cum laude and a master's degree, and I don't buy balderdash. I don't buy silly little things. I don't buy somebody who says, oh, you should do this or you should do that. Give me a reason why. Show me the science. Show me the proof. Show me peer-reviewed science. Show me what it is. I'm sorry, you know, feelings are not reality, and science doesn't care about your feelings. And why would I allow somebody to try and pressure me to be something that I'm not? I kind of like me. I like who I am. And I like men. I think men are fine, except sexually I'm not interested. I like women, and I don't think that all women are interesting to me that way either. But it's just, why would I buy it? Critical thinking skills, people. Biology isn't bigotry. I didn't get born into the wrong body. I got born into a perfectly good one, and I don't want anybody to change it.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you so much. Miriam Ben-Shalom, do you know if they are hiding the figures in the U.S. Regarding suicides committed by men who have transitioned to women or women who have transitioned to men? Do you know if there is transparency in suicide figures by trans in the U.S.?
The states that are lying about the suicide figures are the people in the trans community. Okay, most recently, the United States military decided they were going to allow transgendered people to serve. Okay, cool, you know, whatever. But then you have trans activists who say, like, 45% of transgendered people have tried to commit suicide. You're going to give people like that a gun? Really? You're going to teach them how to shoot it? Really? I don't think so, and I think it's a lie. As I said, I'm no scientist, and I don't have access to research facilities. But I seriously doubt that 45%+ of transgendered people have tried to commit suicide or have committed suicide. I mean, if 45% of the people, there are some who say they have committed suicide, gee, pretty soon, you know, there aren't going to be any transgendered people left. I mean, logic, critical thinking. If half of them are killing themselves, it doesn't make sense, okay? So I think it's balderdash. Like many of the lies coming from trans activists, this is just another big lie. It's what I say.
Why do you think that there is a high rate of suicide, a relatively high rate of suicide amongst transgender? Why do they commit suicide? Why do you think they commit suicide?
Commit suicide. I think kids think about it every now and again. I think if they do want to commit suicide, it's because they're being bullied, they're being harassed, which I don't think is right. But I don't think that there are that many of them that are committing suicide. I just don't believe it. I mean, I was a teacher for 37 years. Do you really think that I didn't have contact? And I don't know of a single kid that I taught that committed suicide. So I don't buy it. Show me the proof. Show me the actual statistics. Show me the peer-reviewed information. Show it to me, and if it's there, I'll change my mind. But I don't think it's there.
In Spain, a few days ago, a transgender boy committed suicide here in Spain. And the LGBT associations, LGBT lobbies criticized Citizen Go and Azteoir for organizing this conference. Because they say that this conference and many of our activities, activities of Azteoir and Citizen Go, are a great pressure for lesbians, for gays, and for transgender people. What do you think about this?
I think it's bullshit. All right. In 2016, 21 transgendered people in the United States were killed. Okay? Any murder, any suicide is an abomination. At that same time, 1,600 plus women were killed or murdered in the United States. You know, if they really cared, where's their compassion towards women? And we don't even know how many children were murdered or trafficked during that time because the statistics aren't available. Frankly, I don't like that anybody commits suicide or is murdered at all. But I'm getting sick and tired of having to cry crocodile tears because one person did something and then the rest of us have to bear the burden. You know, if the transgender community really cared, why don't they offer decent counseling and decent access that's truthful and honest to kids who are thinking about transitioning? Because we have a conference here and we're telling the truth about stuff, we're responsible that poor child committed suicide. What about the attitudes of, you have to be something you're not, you are something that you're really not, you should be this, you should do that? You know, that one child committed suicide is an abomination. How many other people committed suicide during this same time? Is that our fault too? I don't think so. I'm really tired of the guilt trip that the transgender community, their activists, and trans ideology is laying on me. I'm not responsible for telling the truth. The truth did not cause that. And if they don't like it, okay, bad word, are you ready? Too fucking bad.
Muy bien, Miriam. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Miriam.
Ah, foto.
What?